Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are doing well. I hope you guys are staying safe. Today I'm starting a series called the Small Business Series. Basically, if you have a small business, maybe this is going to be of interest to you. I'm going to be talking about some tips for small business and advice, lessons. If you have any questions, you can basically ask me, and if I can answer them, I'll answer. So welcome. So maybe you started your small business, you invested some money in it, but after a while you're like, where is my money? Why can't I seem to have money when I need it? Why can't I seem to have money to pay people salaries? I don't have money, I can't buy maybe material for whatever product you're producing. Why is it that it seems that, yes, I had money in the beginning, but now I don't have money. Where is my money? So today I want to talk about the concept of working capital, how it can be affecting your business, how you can manage working capital better. So I'm reading from Investopedia. Working capital is the measure of a company's liquidity, operational efficiency, and short-term financial health. If a company has substantial positive working capital, then it should have the potential to invest and grow. If a company's current assets do not exceed the current liabilities, then it might have trouble growing or paying back creditors or even go bankrupt. With this concept of working capital, there are three main items we usually look at when you're analyzing working capital for a business. And those three items are receivables, inventories, and payables. I'll just go through them one by one. What are receivables? I'm reading from Investopedia once again. Receivables, also referred to as accounts receivables, are debts owed to by a company by its customers for goods or services that have been delivered but are not yet paid for. Your customers have taken goods from you, but they have not given you the money for it. So those are the receivables. And when you're thinking of receivables, you also have to think about two things. One, the quantity. How much are these receivables? So the dollar amount, the actual value of these receivables. And then number two, there's something called days sales outstanding, which is, in simple terms, it's just the number of days that your customers will stay before paying your money. It can just be a number of days. If you have a product, maybe what's the average amount of days that your customers are going to be staying before giving you your money. Some can stay maybe 1 week, some can stay maybe 30 days. So there is a measure we need to think about. On average, how many days are our customers staying with our money before they give us that money? They have taken the goods, but they have not yet given us the money. So two things: you think about the dollar amount of the receivables, which is the actual value of these receivables, and then another thing, what's the average days of these receivables? How many days do our customers stay with our money before giving it to us? A second item we need to look at when analyzing our working capital is called payables. What are payables? From Investopedia, accounts payables represent a company's obligations to pay off a short-term debt to its creditors or suppliers. So you have your business, you get your products from maybe person Z. Payables are how much you owe this person. Maybe you don't take and pay by cash. Maybe you take on credit and then you'll pay after maybe 1 week or 1 month. So these are payables. And while you are thinking of payables, again, there are two things you need to think about: the actual value of these payables, the dollar amount of the payables, and two, how many days do you actually stay before paying your payables, before giving your creditors the money. It could just be any amount, it could just be any number of days. It could be zero, you pay immediately, or maybe you take a month, you take a week. So you also have to think of this, because all this affects working capital. So the third thing that I want us to look at is called inventories. What are inventories? The term inventory, I'm reading from Investopedia, the term inventory refers to the raw materials used in production, as well as the goods produced that are available for sale. So the raw materials that are used in production and the goods that are already available for sale. So again, you have to think about two things here: the dollar amount, what's the value of these goods that are already available or that work in progress. You have the material, but it's still in production and not yet ready for sale. So we have to think about the dollar amount, and also have to think about number of days. How many days do we stay with inventories? Like, if I bought material today, how long would I stay with this particular item until I sell it off? So what's the number of days? So after we've talked about these three items, we have the receivables, the money that our customers or us, they have that money, they are not the creditors. We have our payables. This is money that we're supposed to pay our creditors, the people who are supplying goods. We've not, but we've not yet paid. And then we have our inventories. Inventory is basically the goods that we have or the product that is ready for sale but we've not yet sold. When you have a small business, sometimes you might find that maybe you have that there are things that can happen that are affecting the actual value cash that you have in your business. One, you have too many receivables. Maybe you are giving your customers too much credit. Either you're giving your customers too much credit or your customers are staying so long before paying you back. So if this happens, it means your receivables is increasing, the number of days that your customers are staying without paying you back is increasing, and this will really affect your cash, because yes, you sold money, yes, you are saying you've made a profit, but you don't have cash. So this can really affect you, because why? You need cash maybe to pay people, you need to pay your suppliers, you need to pay salary. You don't have this money. Why? Because your customers are staying for so long with your money. Another thing is your creditors. We need to think about, okay, fine, how early do I pay my suppliers? Some of these things are not really flexible. Maybe you have to pay immediately. And if you have to pay immediately, but you're giving your customers a week, a month, 60 days to pay you, then this really affects your cash, your actual cash that you have for your business. Another thing is inventories. These are the things, production. These are the goods that are in production or they have already been produced but they are not yet sold. If you have too many of these goods that are in production or they are not yet sold, it really affects your cash, because you have goods but these goods are not cash. So when you're talking about working capital management, we have to think about these three things: receivables, inventories, and payables. If you find that you don't have money, you need to look at these items and think about how you can manage them. Let's start with receivables. The money that your customers have that you've sold goods to them but they have not yet paid you back. You need to think about some things such as, okay, fine, first, how many days are my customers really staying with my money? Is there a way that I can shorten these days? Instead of giving them 20 days, what about giving them 10 days so that they can pay back your money within 10 days? At least here you'll have much more cash earlier on rather than waiting. You can also think about, should I give my customers discounts for early payment? Maybe a discount so that to entice your customer to give you money early. And of course this is a trade-off, because sometimes, okay, when your customers have the money, but if you end up getting into a loan which maybe has high interest rate, you can just think about, okay, fine, maybe if I give them a 5% discount, it's better than me going to take a loan that I'll pay 10% for. So you need to think about this. You can also think about, okay, fine, upfront payment. Maybe you just set a policy that you have to make an upfront payment. Of course, all of this might end up affecting sales of your business, but you really need to think about what's the best way, how can you manage this? Maybe upfront payment, or you tell them, okay, fine, maybe you have to pay 50%, 50% once you make the order, and then the rest you pay after maybe a certain period of days. And some people, the way they make it, maybe 50%. If you're really a small business, maybe, and you really need the money, you can make it in such a way that the money that they pay you is enough for you to produce these goods, so that maybe the leftover is maybe your profit. So at least even if a customer ends up not paying, you don't lose a lot of money. So you need to think about upfront payment, and also set a policy that, okay, this one you can only get this after you've made a full payment. You really need to think about these things. Of course, if you decide that, okay, fine, maybe you're offering sales on credit, but now you decide, no, all my sales are cash, you will end up getting cash, yes, but it might reduce your revenues, and in the end it can reduce your profits. So it's a trade-off really, but you really need to think about how you can work this out. We talked about payables being another component of working capital. This will affect how much cash you have. If you feel like, okay, fine, I really don't have cash, you might start thinking of alternative solutions. Okay, maybe is there a way that I can negotiate with my suppliers that I can extend the days that I take to pay them? Maybe initially you pay them immediately. Is there a way that you can talk to your suppliers so that you can pay them maybe after a week or after 2 weeks, whatever works? This might help you to just get more room, more time frames, that if your customers pay you, then you have money to pay. Of course, some of your suppliers may refuse, so you might just need to go and look for their money. And if you take too long, they might think, okay, fine, this one is a bad customer, so they end up not giving you anything on credit. So this might affect, in the end, it might affect how you're getting your goods. Maybe they said, okay, fine, we're not giving this person until you make payment because it took too long. But you really need to work this out. The last component of working capital that I wanted us to talk about is on inventory. Maybe you have too much inventory. Inventory is staying with you for such a long time. If you have a cash problem, you really need to think about, okay, fine, what can I do with my inventory that is staying for too long? How can I reduce my inventory? You really need to look at your inventory. Look at what goods are slow moving. Maybe this is a slow moving good. You really don't need too much of it because it's slow moving, because it will now restrict your cash. So you can think of, okay, fine, maybe good X is slow moving. Because it's slow moving, I'm going to reduce the quantities at order. Or you can think about, is there a way that I can return to my supplier for some cash back, because maybe this good is not moving at all, so that you can free up some cash. And you really need to think about how much of your goods you stock. Stocking of goods might be good just in case there's a sudden increase in demand. You can meet that demand quickly, but having too much stock is also not good, because it really restricts your cash. It ties up your cash, and there's nothing you can do about it. So you need to think about maybe you shouldn't have too much stock in your business. In the end, it's a trade-off, because if you don't have stock and then maybe a customer wants, they don't get it, maybe they might not be able to wait for you to have it back in stock. So you need to think about it. So that's all, guys. I hope that answers your question. Maybe you have a small business. I hope that answers your question. But okay, fine, why is it that I invested so much in the beginning, but it seems that I don't have money, I don't see my money? Where is my money? I really need cash. And the important thing here is cash, because with cash you can be able to pay your suppliers, you can even be able to pay yourself, you can pay salaries. So if you're a small business and you're struggling, you don't know where your cash is, you don't see your cash, maybe you need to look at these three items. You need to look at your receivables, you need to look at your payables, you need to look at your inventories and see ways in which you can manage them. So that's all, guys. That's all for today. I hope I answered the question. Like, maybe you have a small business. I hope I answered you. And if you have any other questions, please leave them in the comment section down below. And if you have a small business, please let me know in the comment section down below what it is, what is not making you sleep at night, what other questions do you have for small business. And if I know some answers, I might address them in the next video. So let me know in the comment section down below. If you like this video, please don't forget to click the like button. If you're not yet subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe right here. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.